إذا كنت تريد أن تكون على مذهب السلف تعلم مذهب السلف.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، فعباد الرحمن. The characteristics of the slaves of Ar-Rahman from them is that they do not take an innocent life. As Allah Ta'ala said, وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. They do not kill an innocent life that Allah has forbidden except with just cause. فَلَا شَكْ أَنَّ قَتْلَ النَّفْسَ الْبَرِيئَةِ الَّتِي حَرَّمَهَا اللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَمْرٌ شَدِيدٌ وَإِثْمٌ عَظِيمٌ وَجَرِيمَةٌ فِي الدِّينِ. For no doubt, taking the life of an innocent soul in which Allah Ta'ala has forbidden is a severe affair and a grave sin and a crime in the religion of Al-Islam. وَلِذَلِكَ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي كِتَابِهِ الْكِرِيمِ مِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ كَتَبَنَا عَلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ أنه من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. And due to this, Allah Ta'ala said in His noble book, because of that we ordained for the children of Israel that if anyone killed a person, not in retaliation of murder and to spread mischief in the land, it would be as if he killed all of mankind. And if anyone saved a life, it would be as if he saved the life of all of mankind. For subhanAllah, look at how Allah Ta'ala equated the killing of one innocent person to the killing of the whole of mankind. And Ibn Hajar rahimahullah said in relation to this ayah, وَجَعَلَ قَتْلَ النَّفْسِ الْوَاحِدَةِ كقتل جميع الناس مبالغة في تعظيم أمر القتل الظلم وتفخيما لشأنه. So he subhanahu wa ta'ala made the killing of a single innocent soul like the killing of the whole of mankind as an emphasis of the severity of the affair of killing unjustly and as an amplification of its affair. كما أن قتل جميع الناس أمر عظيم القبح عند كل أحد فكذلك قتل الواحد يجب أن يكون كذلك. يعني just as killing the whole of mankind is a disgraceful affair with anyone, then likewise killing a single person should be just as despicable and despised and disgraceful. وقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات المهلكات ومنها قتل النفس التي حرمها الله إلا بالحق. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, avoid seven destructive affairs, and from them is killing an innocent soul which Allah has forbidden except with a right. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام لن يزال المؤمن في فسحة من دينه ما لم يصب دما حرام. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said, a believer remains in the fastness and expansiveness of his religion as long as he does not shed any unlawful blood. فالمؤمن الصادق يعلم خطر ارتكاب هذا الذنب العظيم ويعلم أنه من أعظم الذنوب والمعاصي فيجتنبه ولا يقربه. So the true believer knows without a shadow of a doubt the danger of committing this terrible atrocity, and he knows that is from the greatest of sins and disobediences, so he avoids it and he does not approach it. ويعلم أنه سبب لدخول كثير من الناس إلى النار ويعلم أن عقوباته شديدة. And likewise he knows, the true believer knows, that it is the reason for many people entering into the fire, and he knows that its punishments are severe. كما جاء في قوله تعالى ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما. As Allah Ta'ala said, and whoever kills a believer intentionally, his recompense is the fire to abide therein, and the wrath and the curse of Allah are upon him, and a great punishment is prepared for him. And it has come in the narration that Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma said, إِنَّ مِنْ وَرْطَاتِ الْأُمُورِ أَلَّتِي لَا مَخْرَجَ لِمَنْ أَوْقَعَ نَفْسَهُ فِيهَا سَفْكَ الدَّمِّ الْحَرَامِ بِغَيْرِ حِلِّهِ. And Abdullah ibn Umar said, one of the evil affairs or evil deeds with bad consequences from which there is no escape for the one who is involved in it is to kill someone unlawfully. So look, ya ma'ashir al-ahibbah, at this beautiful religion of ours and how it has come to preserve life and limb despite the lies and the rumors that are spread, and despite that which is attributed to this pure religion, this deen al-qayyim, by these extremists that show no remorse or regret in taking innocent lives. And even more severe than this, that they claim them to be halal, that they claim them to be lawful and permissible to take. Wallahu musta'an. And wallahi, by Allah, they will be held accountable and questioned by Allah yawm al-qiyamah for the one who even killed a small bird unjustly will be questioned. So how about the one who commits mass murder? As has come in the hadith that the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, من قتل عصفورا عبثا عج إلى الله عز وجل يوم القيامة يقول يا ربي إن فلانا قتلني عبثا ولم يقتلني لمنفعه. As has come in the hadith that the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, whoever kills a small bird or a sparrow for no reason or out of jest, it will beseech Allah on the day of resurrection, saying, oh Lord, so-and-so killed me for no reason, and he did not kill me for any beneficial purpose. Imagine, ya ikhwani, takhayyalu. Imagine that a small bird will beseech Allah yawm al-qiyamah and testify against the one who killed it for no reason other than amusement or sport. So how about the one who takes an innocent life? How will his affair be yawm al-qiyamah when he is stood in front of his Lord and the people are standing in front of their Lord, urratan, huffatan, gharlan, unclothed, barefooted and uncircumcised, and the slain will come, the one who was killed will come, muta'alliqun bi-ra'si sahibihi, he will come holding onto the head of his killer, saying, thumma qal, wallahi laqad, thumma qal, yaqul, rabbi sal hadha lima qatalani, he'll be saying, my Lord, ask him, why did he kill me? ثم قال والله لقد أنزلها الله ثم ما نسخها. Then he said, by Allah, Allah revealed it and never abrogated anything of it. Referring to the ayah that we just mentioned, whoever kills a believer intentionally, then فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها, then his recompense is the fire to abide therein. وغضب الله عليه, and Allah's wrath is upon him. ولعنه, and Allah's curse is upon him. وعد له عذابا عظيما, and he has prepared for him a great punishment. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. And in another narration of the same hadith, that the one who is killed will come holding onto the head of his killer and saying, my Lord, he killed me. And Allah Azza wa Jal will say to him, Ta'ist, may you be ruined. وَيُذْهَبُ بِهِ إِلَى النَّارِ, and he will be taken to the fire. نَسَّلَ اللَّهِ السَّلَامُ وَالْعَافِيَةِ. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على مبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وكذلك قال نبينا عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقبض العلم وتكثر الزلازل ويتقارب الزمان وتظهر الفتن ويكثر الهرج وهو القتل حتى يكثر فيكم المال فيفيض. And likewise, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, the hour will not be established until knowledge will be taken away. Earthquakes will be very frequent. Time will pass quickly. Trials and tribulations will appear. Murders will increase. And money will overflow amongst you. فصدق النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. For how many of these signs do we see happening before our very eyes? And the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, والذي نفسي بيده ليأتين على الناس زمان لا يدري القاتل في أي شيء قتل. And النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said, by the one who my soul is in his hands, there will come a time wherein the one who is killing does not know why he killed. وَلَا يَدْرِي الْمَقْتُولُ عَلَىٰ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ قُتِلْ. And the one who was killed does not know what he had been killed for. For subhanallah, how often do such occurrences take place in our time? How often do we hear people being killed due to senseless violence that has escalated? People being killed due to a look, a bad look, or a stare. And we even hear that the Muslim youth are entangled in this affair. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. But alhamdulillah, our deen has come to preserve life, as we are even forbidden from pointing a weapon at one another, even if it be jokingly or in jest. As the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام said, مَنْ أَشَارَ إِلَىٰ أَخِيهِ بِحَدِيدَهِ فَإِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ تَلْعَنُهُ حَتَّى يَنْزِعُ. Whoever points a weapon at his brother, then indeed the angels curse him up until he stops. And in another narration, لَا يُشِرْ أَحَدُكُمْ إِلَىٰ أَخِيهِ بِالصِّلَاحِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَدْرِي لَعَلَّ الشَّيْطَانِ يَنْزَعُ فِي يَدِهِ فَيَقَعُ فِي حُفْرَةٍ مِّنَ النَّارِ. And in another narration, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, none of you should point a weapon towards his brother, for verily, he does not know that perhaps the shaytan will cause that which is in his hand to slip, and thus he would fall into the pit of fire. فَيَا إِخْوَةِ, it's an amr that is shadeed, عَظِيمٌ, it's an affair that is tremendous, that we have to be warned against and be careful of. Yani pointing weapons at one another, even if it be jokingly, even if we were to grab a knife or a stick and play about with one another and aim it at each other, that we have to be careful, ya ayyuhal ikhwah, because these occurrences can occur. How many stories do we hear of people joking around with firearms and weapons pointing them at one another, and then the firearm goes off, and then he has killed an innocent life. And then this hadith is applicable to him. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. اللهم اعفو عنا اللهم إنا نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وأقيم الصلاة.